Well, good evening. Welcome to the River Welland. The upper reaches getting on towards Market Deeping in Lincolnshire. We're here for some early season bream fishing. I'm Richard Grange, Angling Times match editor, and it's going to be my job with Iain Toombs to hopefully put together a decent bag of bream on the opening day of the season. It's a magical day, still for many people. Fewer and fewer, it has to be said these days, but the fish are still there if you can catch them, if you know what to do, where to find them. Prebaiting is a big part of finding them, probably the biggest part, because it's not enough to turn up on the morning, put in a few balls of ground bait and expect the bream to be there. They just won't. The Welland is a massive river. There's 800 odd pegs alone on the lower reaches. They can be anywhere and they can move overnight, so you have to do your homework first, do your groundwork, put the hard work in, find them. Hopefully you'll recoup the rewards. So a little bit about the River Welland first. It's a river you've probably heard a lot of, especially if you're an older angler. It was made very famous throughout the 60s, 70s and the early part of the 80s by match anglers, mainly. Ivan Marks obviously is synonymous with the river. He claimed many of his biggest match wins on the river, but also the likes of Robin Harris, the world champion and Division One national winner in the same year back in the 60s, the likely lads from Leicester, but it also attracted a lot of anglers from Barnsley, Sheffield, Doncaster, that the angling hotbed up there. It's produced anglers such as Alan Scotton, Dennis White, Tommy Pickering. They'll all have fished this river in the big matches at some point. So what are we up against on the river? It's not a river like the Severn, the Warwickshire Avon or the Trent. It's a Fenland River, and that means it's slow, it's deep, it's wide, it's prone to a lot of weed, and it's also very exposed. Any wind that there is will come ripping down the river, and that can make fishing very, very difficult. The part of river we've targeted, where we've found the bream, is pretty nondescript, really. It's wide, I would say, around 60 metres wide, probably a little bit less. Depth-wise, 8 or 9 foot down the middle. Very steep drop-off, a couple of rod lengths out on either side. Now, the bream can come on top of that in the shallower water, but generally speaking, as it gets light in the morning, they'll retreat to the deeper water. So that's where we'll be feeding, that's where we'll be raking the area, and that's where we'll be fishing. So having found the bream, raking is the next job. It's a laborious task. It's not exciting, it's not glamorous. You really just want to get fishing and putting some feed in, doing fishing things really, but it's important. Without it, you'll be chucking into weed, this sort of stuff. You do not want to put your hook in that. You want to get as much of that out as you can. This has come from 2 or 3 chucks with a rake. So you can see we're not in high summer, but there's a lot in the river already, and that will get worse throughout the summer. So it's important to clear it. It does two purposes. First of all, obviously, it makes a clear bed to fish on. You don't get your rigs snagged. It's easy fishing. It makes sense, basically. Secondly, raking the swim stirs the bottom up, drags the weed out, disturbs the mud. That releases all manner of small insects, crustaceans, larvae and so on, that bloodworms that the bream will feed on. So this will cloud the water, and if it's gin clear, that's a big, big help. That will attract fish in, not immediately, but within, I would say, an hour or two of raking, they should be mooching around and having a look. Keep doing that regularly, and you'll have that cloud in the water, a clouded area generally, that's so very different to what is either side of where you're planning to fish. The fish know that, and they will stay there. So we'll talk a little bit about the rake, first of all. Now, it's not a garden, well, it is a garden rake, it's part of it. This amazingly costs 10 quid to build. All it is, it's 2 garden rake heads detached from the main shaft, angle grinded down, linked together on the metal bar you can see running there with a dozen or so cable ties. That's not going anywhere, even if you hit the biggest of weed beds. Attached to that's a good length. We've got around 30 metres of good strong rope there. Now, I'm not Mr. Universe, it has to be said. I don't think I'm going to be chucking it at 30 metres, but you only have to fish down the middle, so we're not looking to hit the horizon with it. That's reinforced at the joint there, plenty of electrician's tape, and a grip there, grip hold of the rake for slinging it out. So that's a rake, dead easy to make, very effective, you can't do without one. So once we've done the raking, we've cleared the spots, we're ready to start putting some feed in. Lots of this stuff. Now that's flake maize, that's 100% pure food. Bream absolutely love that. So we're going to put quite a bit of this kit in over the next few days, and that's what we'll show you tomorrow.